This is pink aglaonema's plant cutting, which is growing in this small pot for 4 months. There is no doubt roots are grown already. Only I am concerned about its growth. These leaves were absent on the day I had propagated this cutting. Its height has been increased slightly since then. So this happens due to the nutrition deficiency where a plant grows slowly. So these are the reasons for which I want to repot it. But the problem is this cutting is growing in cocopeat. Its root will be disturbed if I'll take it out straight away like this. And I have the fear to lose it after repotting, as this is not the right season. It is very small and not healthy also. So I will repot it without following the actual repotting process. Let's see it. First, I will take out half of the cocopeat from the pot. On the other side, I'll mix soil and compost. No need to mix cocopeat in this mixture as it is in the pot already. Now I will fill the pot with potting mix. Mix it gently without disturbing the roots. Once it is done, fill it with a leftover potting mix. Mix it lightly. And in the end, don't forget to water. It's that simple. For so many plants, I have done repotting this way. These are a few plants that are growing nicely. You can go for a bigger pot once the roots need larger space to grow. A plant receives nutrients from the compost, whereas soil holds the nutrients. So whenever you add fertilizer to the soil, microbes present in the soil start acting, they break down it, and in the end, plants get their food from the soil. So soil and compost are the most essential things that a plant needs to grow continuously. This is how you can help your plant by fixing the repotting or transplant shock. Now onwards, don't hesitate for repotting. You can do it anytime and in any season. Thank you so much for watching this. I'll meet you soon with a new video. Till then, take care.